Students, in this part, that the second unit, we last class we saw about the igneous and sedimentary rocks. Now we will see about the metamorphic rocks. Right? So the metamorphic rock, it is we are seeing about in the second unit. We are seeing about the mineralogy and petrology. Mineralogy we have already see about the minerals and other things. Petrology we are seeing. Petrology mainly deals with the rock and the formation of the rocks. And we already saw what are the things that is happening with igneous rocks and the metamorphic rocks, this sedimentary rocks. Today we will be seeing about the metamorphic rocks. All of you know that again and again I am telling you, this is a rock formation where the hot magma is coming out and it forms a through volcano. If it is coming out, it forms a extrusive rocks, right? So in the bottom, when the magma gets solidifies under the earth surface, we call it as intrusive rocks. And the intrusive rocks, if it is between 10 meters, almost kilometers under the earth surface, if it is there around 2 kilometers, we call it a hyperbasal lump. And when these rocks that is coming out and it is extrusive rocks are undergoes a weathering action, and due to erosion, it is taken and settled and deposited somewhere else. It is called as a sedimentary rocks. And the sedimentary rocks and also the igneous rocks undergo a very heat and temperature. So it calls a metamorphic rocks. Meta means complete change. So this metamorphic rock does not consist of the properties of the sedimentary rocks, does not consist the properties of the igneous rocks. It is a newly formed rocks. So that we will be seeing now. So here you can, I have already explained the rock cycle. So metamorphic rocks are formed from the older rocks where they are subjected to increased pressure, temperature and the shearing strength at considerable depth in the earth crust. The older rocks may be sedimentary, igneous and other metamorphic rocks. During metamorphism, what happens? Metamorphism is the complete change. So recrystallization process takes place by which the minerals and other, that is silica, potassium, calcium, everything reacts with the heat and temperature. Then it will be again mixed together to form the newly formed material, that is the metamorphic rocks, the metamorphism. So metamorphic change in the rocks are primarily results of three main factors that are sometimes called the agents of metamorphism. So what is the three main agents? Heat, pressure and the chemical change. Right? The agents may act on rocks individually or collectively. So what is thermal metamorphism? Is the heat factor that has played a very important role. Dynamic metamorphism, there is no or very little formation of new minerals. And new structures and textures are imposed on the affected rock. And the third one, it is the contact metamorphism by which the rocks are close to magmatic intrusions, injections and the lava flows. Okay, so these are the three types by which the metamorphism happens in this type of rocks. And the dynamo, the five types are the dynamo thermal metabolism. Here what happens there? It is a regional metabolism. It is involves the development of large scale changes in structural and chemical composition of pre-existing rocks and combined action of the new existing already pre-existing rocks are undergoing some changes due to the pressure, temperature and chemical reaction. This metamorphism will follow. The plutonic metamorphism, it is high temperature and static pressure operate together at greater depths below the earth surface. So what are the textures of the metamorphic rock? Crystalloblastic texture, the whole of crystalline texture of metamorphic rock is called the crystalloblastic structures. That is, the crystals show a perfect crystal outline in the crystalloblastic structure. Then porphyroblastic texture, where ideoblasts, that is a perfect crystal outline, occur as large crystal embedded in a fine grained ground mass. So here it is, you can see the crystal showing a very perfect crystal outline. Here the large crystal are embedded in a fine grained ground mass. So you can see the examples. This is a example of this crystalloblastic texture, then porphyroblastic texture. This is a crystalloblastic, this is porphyroblastic. Here you can see the textures. Then granoblastic texture. Here what happens, the granules, that is the crystal will form as a granules, and the granules can be very well seen in the thing. So it is a equidimensional and it is called the granoblastic. So palimpsest are the relict texture, the remnant texture of the parent rock found preserved in the metamorphic rock, and it is called as the palimpsest structure. So here the changes is very minimum because the parent, what are the properties that are happening in the parent rock will be reflected here. Okay, so you can see, right, some changes of the metamorphic rocks. And cataclastic structure, it is found in rocks such as crush, breakers and myelonites. These rocks are formed mainly on the influence of shearing stress. So particularly mainly the metamorphic rocks are formed due to the pressure and temperature. This structure textures are formed, cataclastic structures are formed mainly due to the shearing stress. Harder constituents of rocks are broken into pieces while softer ones are crushed to powders. You can see here, right? So this is one type, different types of this structure. Okay, slaty structure. So in the slaty structures, you can see this is the formation of the slaty structures. So develops the shales that have undergone slight metamorphism. Okay, so rocks showing a slaty structures are very fine ground, primarily microscopic flakes of mica, right? So it will have a flake like structure, very thin flakes. The structure is caused due to the parallel orientation of flaky minerals, mainly micas and chlorates. So the next one, stichostic structures. You can see this is the first one I told you, it is a slaky structure. So this is a stichostic structures. So here what happens now, the metamorphic rock is the alignment of minerals in parallel layers. Okay, so the arrangement due to the recrystallization during regional metamorphism. Third one, genisos structure. Genisos means it is originally formed. So recrystallized under the condition of high grade metamorphism, the light and dark colored minerals may segregate into alternate bands and parallel to the schistosity. So here it will have some light color, that the colors that will be emitted. The light colored band are composed of quartz and feldspar, and the dark colored bands are composed of ferromagnesium materials. So here this you can see. Okay, so it is have different colored materials that is formed of this. Granules, we can see it is granules. It is mainly made up of granules like this formed here. So this is the formation, structural formation. And it is a equidimensional mineral such as quartz, feldspar, pyroxenes and calcite. For quartzite and marbles, it is a characteristic structures. You can see all the four types of structures that I have told you. And the next one, from some of the types of metamorphic rocks that we will see, one is marble. So marble, all of you think of marble when you think of Taj Mahal. We will think of Taj Mahal, we have to think of marbles. Essentially a granular metamorphic rock composed chiefly of recrystalline limestones. The limestones from the sedimentary rocks undergoes a pressure and temperature which is the main formation of the marble. So that we are using it mostly in the building material. It is characterized by the granular structures, but the grain size shows considerable variations. Marbles are generally white, but various impurities in the marbles mixed together in the rocks. So it is showing some other colors like green or black, grey, yellow. Some colors are due to the dirt materials that are found in the marbles. Number one. Number two, gneiss. Gneiss is a megascopically crystalline foliated metamorphic rock. Okay. So it is characterized by segregation of constituent minerals into layers or bands. These are coarse-grained rocks. Right, having gneiss as structure, gneiss are more commonly derived in the higher grade regional metamorphism of igneous rocks. They may also formed from the sedimentary rocks. The next one, it is the slate. Right, slate is also, you can see it is also black in color, and you can see it is a finely grained metamorphic rock where marble is coarsely grained, and it is having a slaty cleavage. When we break into it, it will break by layers. And it can be split into thin sheets, that's what I told you. And it is made up of platy and flaky minerals of the slate under the dominant stresses operating during the process of metamorphism. The color of the slate may vary commonly from gray to black, but may be green, yellow, brown and red due to the presence of the dirt. Okay, all minerals will have the pure colors, but due to the presence of the dirt, their color may change. So here also it is commonly gray to black, but due to the dirt and other things, it is changing to green, yellow, brown and red. Okay, it is mainly made up of dynamic metamorphism. The fourth one, it is the cyst. They are post-grained metamorphic rock which show well-developed foliations. It will be like a foliated rocks. Okay, and cysti along which the rock may be easily broken. It can be easily broken into small crystallized pieces. Where you see the slate, it can be easily broken as a thin sheets. Right? So these are the products of regional metamorphism. The next one, it is a quartzite. The main thing, it is the composition here will be a silica. It is mainly from the quartz material. It is a hard, dense, siliceous metamorphic rock. It is made up of granular textures and it is a very compact rock. It is a strong rock and it is when it is broken down, it is having a very rough surface. Hard rock made up of silica, so it will be very rough surface, and it is generally formed from limestone by high grade metamorphism. High grade means we are having a very high temperature and very high pressure acting on it. This quartzite forms. Okay. So the next one, what is the importance of this metamorphic rocks? As you all know, this marbles, as I told you, marbles are used for the flooring and also for the decorative purpose. And mainly you think of Taj Mahal. Taj Mahal is completely made up of marble stones. Used as a building stones for flooring and also commonly used for the sculptures. Right, for the sculptures and also for the building material. Metamorphic gneiss is also used as a building material as small stones. And also for the flooring and also the gravestones are also used for the decorative purpose for the various, because this gneiss can be easily be worked with. Okay. So the next one, it is a slate. So you have taken the slate is a very thin material, layer by layer material. So we are also using as a flooring material like that of the tiles. Okay. Instead of tiles, they can go in for a slate, and also for the kitchen basins and other things, they are using it for the slate as a material. And the next one, it is all the mostly this metamorphic rocks are used for the walls, gardens, etc. High percentage of mica group. Quartzite slab are used to cover walls as a roofing and other things. So this is all the metamorphism, and now we will see entire usage of the rocks, igneous rocks or metamorphic rocks or the sedimentary rocks, what it is. Only lithological and structural studies are fully sufficient for any kind of usage. Not more detailed studies necessary. What is the type of rock that we can use it for the particular usage? Laboratory and in situ studies can be done even to find out the properties. And what are the engineering properties? The first one, it is the compressive strength. All of you know, compressive strength depends upon the type of rock. Igneous rocks are more highly high compressive strength compared to the sedimentary rocks. Metamorphic rock also, whether it is formed from sedimentary rocks or igneous rock. So based on that, it is having a very high strength, okay, compressive strength. So the compressive strength is nothing but the resistance of the material towards the outside force, the shear strength. The shear strength is particularly based on the crystal formation or the granular formation that is there. Due to the shearing stresses, due to the particle sizes in between moving from one against from one another, we can form, when a paper is cut through its scissors, the paper fails in shear. Similar to that, the stones fails in shear, if that is of sandstones or slates where it is made up of layer after layer. But granular basalt are made up of very good hard materials, it will not be failing. Modulus of elasticity is the within elastic limit, stress is proportional to strain. So almost all the rock materials except sedimentary rocks having a very good modulus of elasticity. Okay. So the next one, porosity. The porosity will be very less in the igneous rocks and metamorphic rocks, but it will be very little bit higher in the limestones. Okay, so actually the ceramics, metallurgy materials, manufacturing and earth sciences, all these things will give you, and it is directly proportional to the permeability. When porosity is high, permeability will be very high. So that type of rock we have to see. Okay, so the resistance to disintegration on repeated wetting and drying. So I told you that sedimentary rocks are very undergo after repeated wetting and drying, it will be easily dissolved in the water. But this granites, marbles is having a very good strong. Other properties that we are worried about is the triaxial strength, crushing strength, density, frost and fire resistance, toughness, hydrophobic properties, the resistance to water, cracking of concrete, abrasive resistance, durability, hardness, binding properties and the appearance. These are the properties that we have to consider when we are using the rocks for the building purpose as a civil engineer. And this can be easily found out either from the laboratory or from the casting center, that is in the site itself we can find out. And one more thing is that the igneous rocks are very good in the properties, that is strength and hardness, everything, compared to the sedimentary rocks. But metamorphic rock, it is mainly based on the formation, whether it is from igneous rocks or the sedimentary rocks, that the properties may differ. Okay, so by this I complete the second unit, and we will go from the next class, we will see about the third unit. Thank you.